I'm going to call this meeting of the New York State Housing Finance Agency, New York State Affordable Housing Corporation, State of New York Mortgage Agency, State of New York Municipal Bond Bank Agency, the Tobacco Settlement Financing Corporation to order. I'm going to turn things over to the secretary, who will take the requisite legal steps to formally open our meetings.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'm Dr. Todd Sherman, representing Robert Mujica, Director of the Division of the Budget, is participating in our meeting from the New York State Division of the Budget Conference Center. I note that Mark Schroeder, participating from the agency's Buffalo Regional Office, and notice of these locations has been made public, and the public has the right to attend and observe the proceedings from either location. I'm going to ask for a motion and a second to call to order the January 26, 2017 meetings of HFA, AHC, Sunny May, NBBA, TSFC. A motion for HFA and AHC.
So moved.
Second.
A motion for Sunny May.
So moved.
Second.
Second.
Okay, motions for NBBA and TSFC.
So moved.
Second. All right. As items are presented to each board throughout today's meetings, these motions and seconds will be used unless specific items call for a different vote or unless any board member or director wishes to report his or her board differently.
Let me turn things over to President Rubin for the President's report.
Great. It's March.
We're missing Marge and Joyce.
Yep.
I wonder if we can wait 1 second.
Yep.
Is Joyce with us?
I think Joyce must be in the lady.
Okay. All right.
She was in.
Okay. Not a problem. Thanks.
Yeah, Joyce is sick.
All right. So, good morning, everybody. Thank you. We've already had a busy meeting, so we'll try to be efficient here. At this morning's Mortgage Insurance Committee meeting, 7 projects were approved for insurance, representing 543 affordable housing units located in Monroe, Nassau, Dutchess, New York, and Bronx counties. On the HFA agenda shortly, we're going to be seeking your approval on several items, including 5 new financings. These projects located in New York City, Monroe, and Nassau counties represent 870 units of affordable housing. Both the Audit and Governance Committee meetings, agencies meeting, and you have already considered various administrative and financial items. And then later at AHC, you're going to review new awards being sought of over $4 million, representing assistance to an estimated 170 units of housing, all outside of New York City. In January, just to review a couple of other things, January has seen the governor's State of the State addresses laying out his 2017 plan for the state. And in each address, he highlighted projects proposed for the region of the state that he was speaking about, as well as an overall framework. I attended January 10th in Westchester and January 9th here in New York City, which was the kickoff at the World Trade Center. And it's a typically big and aggressive agenda. He also introduced the executive budget on the 17th of January. The $150-some-odd billion budget didn't really get a formal address the way last year's did, but we did. He did briefings for the Senate Democrats, the Senate Republicans, the NIDC, the Assembly Democrats, Assembly Republicans, and then the press. And I went to the Senate Democrats and the Assembly Democrats, you know, I thought they all went pretty well. Again, it's an aggressive budget. And I'm sure you all have been reading some, hey, just have been reading about it in the last week or so. The signature items this year are clearly the college affordability item plan, some infrastructure projects. And then on our end, the plan reappropriates the $2 billion in housing funds that we had last year that are still subject to an MOU being signed. So we have 2 ways forward this year. We can either get the MOU signed between the 3 parties or get the budget adopted as is and get $2 billion that way, plus an additional $500 million for FY 2020. So the total housing plan capital will be $2.5 billion if the budget is adopted, if the executive budget is adopted, as well as some ongoing program appropriations. So we are looking forward to budget season, my budget hearing is February 9th, and staff has already started doing all the preparation for that, which is pretty extensive. Went very well last year, and I expect it'll be good this year, although the, it does seem like the legislature is going to be more probing with their questions last year than there was, this year than they were last year. Probing. So that is that. The other kind of interesting thing that happened, let me just see what else I've got before I get into this. No, that's basically it. The other thing that the agency's been involved in is a negotiation of a, the newly named 421A tax abatement program, now known as the Affordable Housing New York Program, so we don't fit 421A anymore. Well, just to keep it very simple, this is a major tax abatement, very comprehensive tax abatement program, operative only in New York City, with respect to New York City property taxes, designed for years and years to incent the development of additional affordable rental housing with an affordable component. It has to be renewed every 4 years. It lapsed at the end of 2016. The end of 2015, because the legislature wasn't able to agree on certain conditions that the governor and others had insisted on. We were able to negotiate, along with the chamber, an agreement, an agreed upon plan that satisfied all the parties, I think, between organized labor, the Building Construction Trades Council, and the larger real estate developers. And the bottom line is that we've now introduced, or the governor's introduced, a program bill and a bill as part of the budget. So there's again two paths forward here that would restart the 421A program, enabling thousands, I think thousands of new affordable units to be developed every year, as well as a bunch of market rate units throughout the city, and also improve somewhat the affordability measures that were in the previous legislation. And finally, guaranteed that on very large projects, 300 units and over, in the highest rent areas of New York, average wages would be required for those projects. So fair, with the governor uses fair wages, and the development community agreed to them. So I assume that they view them as fair as well. So it's a good outcome for everybody, I think. And we're hopeful that the legislature will pass that bill as well as our housing plan budget. And let us continue our good work and accelerate it. We've had a bunch of events, as you expect, since the last time we met, December 15th, the ribbon cutting, and I think there have been other ribbon cuttings and groundbreakings. I've done a few State of the State budget presentations, most recently at the Fort Greene Council Senior Center in Brooklyn. Bless you.
Thank you.
Which was interesting. Fort Greene Council Senior Center.
No, as well.
You know, well?
Absolutely.
You probably know some of the folks there. Yeah. They ask your question. And then Friday, we've got our next town hall, our first one of 2017. So it has been a busy couple months, as always, and we look forward to continuing in the month ahead. Back to you.
Okay. Alex is going to do, we talk about committee actions.
I'm going to try to do this fast. Everybody was here. The Mortgage Insurance Committee met and approved various projects: Moxie A. Rigby, Savannah Hall, Kingsbridge Heights, Cornerstone, 788 Fox Street, 1088 and 1102 Washington Avenue, and Quinn City Lofts. The Audit Committee met, adopted minutes, and then received an extensive presentation from staff on accomplishments during the year and recommended the approval of the agency's financial statements. After presentation by Ernst & Young, they adopted a resolution for the internal audit report on the Mortgage Insurance Fund project, adopted a resolution approving the audited supplementary financial information report, and received their Audit Committee evaluation materials. The Governance Committee also met, adopted minutes, recommended the approval of the board's self-evaluation, recommended the review and approval of the agency's mission statements as proposed to be amended, adopted a resolution recommending the approval of the disposition report, reviewed the contract with Doug Dilla, and reviewed legal services contract with various firms, and also received the governance evaluation materials.
Jeez.
I'm good.
Boy, you're good at that. Okay, we'll now present items shared by HFA, AHC, State Mortgage Agency, MBBA, and TSFC. Now let's record the approval of the minutes.
The minutes of the meetings of HFA, AHC, Sunny May, MBBA, and TSFC held on December 15th shall be deemed approved absent correction from the members or directors.
We'll now move to the shared action items. Item two, resolution reviewing and approving mission statements of the agencies. This item was discussed earlier today at the governance committee meetings.
So all I'm going to say here is the governance committee recommended the approval of the mission statements as amended, with a comment from the committee chair that we take up the mission statements again this year for some further proposed changes. The one thing I failed to mention at the governance committee meeting that I do want to mention here is that the item was accompanied by a detailed report on measurements from each agency, where each agency provided everything that they had done during the year to test the performance against the mission. So I think all the board members were here for that, so I'm assuming no one has any comments. And before all five boards is a resolution of each of the agencies reviewing the mission statements, assuming the first and second is previously entered. All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Aye. Resolution adopted.
Item three, approval of board self-evaluation. This item was discussed at the governance committee meetings and is now before the boards.
Here again, the board discussed this, the committee discussed it with all board members present. There was a sense that the board felt that the board was carrying out its duties adequately, more than adequately. So now all before all five boards is a resolution of each of the agencies concerning the board self-evaluations, assuming the first and second is previously entered for all five agencies. All in favor will signify by saying aye.
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 Motion to carry, resolution adopted.
At this point, Alice will call to order the Finance Committee meetings of HFA, State Mortgage Agency, MBBA, and TSFC, which will be held jointly with the other board meetings.
Okay. I'm going to ask for a motion and a second to call to order the January 26th, 2017 Finance Committee meetings of HFA, MBBA, Sunny May, TSFC. A motion for HFA.
So moved.
Second. Todd?
Okay.
Okay.
Second.
Thank you.
A motion for Sunny May.
So moved.
Second.
Thank you. And a motion for tobacco and MBBA.
So moved.
Second.
Beautiful. As items are presented to each committee throughout today's meetings, these motions and seconds will be used unless specific items call for a different vote.
Second. Minutes.
So the minutes of the 62nd meeting of HFA and the 21st meeting of Sunny May, as well as the 8th MBBA and TSFC committee meeting, shall be deemed approved absent corrections from the members of directors.
Item four, resolution approving the annual investment report and quarterly investment report.
This is basically a consent item, so unless board members have comments on this report, can we move to the vote? Now before the committee and boards is a resolution of each of the agencies approving the annual report on investments and a quarterly report on investments for AHC. Assuming the first and second is previously entered for all four finance committees, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion is carried, resolution adopted. Assuming the first and second is previously entered for the boards, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion is carried, resolution adopted.
Item five, resolution approving the final annual budget program budgets, HFA and MBBA. Unless board members have comments on this report, we're going to move on to the vote.
Now before the HFA and MBBA boards is a resolution of HFA and MBBA adopting program budgets, assuming the first and second is previously entered for HFA and MBBA. All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
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 Motion to carry, resolution adopted.
Item six, budget and financial plan results for fiscal year ending 2016. This item is listed as an action item in the board materials, but it should just be an information item without a vote. It presents the results of last year's budget. We came in under budget. Item seven, resolution approving the agency's financial statements for fiscal year 2016. Earlier today at the audit committee meetings, a detailed presentation was made in connection with this item. It is now before the boards. Unless board members have questions or comments, we'll move on to the vote.
Now before the Sunny May HFA and MBBA and TSFC board for approval is a resolution of each of those agencies approving the audited financial statements for fiscal year 2016. Assuming the first and second is previously entered for all four agencies, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion to carry, the resolution adopted.
Item eight, resolution approving the HFA audited supplementary financial information. Unless board members have comments on this report, we'll move on to the vote.
This was also addressed at the audit committee. Now before the HFA board is a resolution of HFA approving the audited supplementary financial information report, assuming the first and second is previously entered for the HFA Board. All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion is carried and the resolution adopted.
We're going to move on to the consent items. No discussion on these items unless board members so request. Item 9, a resolution approving the agency's annual procurement report for fiscal year 2015 and 16 and review of the agency's fourth quarterly procurement report.
So now before the boards is a resolution of each of the agencies approving these annual procurement reports. Assuming the first and second is previously entered for the boards, all in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion is carried and the resolution adopted.
Item 10, a resolution approving the agency's public authorities reporting information systems filing report.
And this is again is the report that had the mission statement evaluation. Now before the boards is a resolution of each of the boards accepting a filing under the public authorities reporting information system. Assuming the first and second is previously entered for all five agencies, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion is carried. Resolution adopted.
Item 11, resolution approving acquisition and disposition and inventory guidelines and reports.
Addressed at the Governance Committee meeting. Now before the HFA Sunny Main MBBA Board is a resolution of those boards approving the disposition report. Assuming the first and second previously entered for HFA Sunny Main MBBA, all in favor, please signify by saying
aye.
Aye.
Motion is a carry. Resolution adopted.
The next item on the agenda is an information item. There'll be no discussion on this unless board members or directors so request. Item 12, current agency procurements in the lobbying restricted period. There being no further items on MBBA and TSFC boards and committees, Alex will ask for a motion and a second to adjourn those meetings.
Assuming the first and second previously entered for the MBBA and TSFC finance committees, all in favor of adjourning, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion is carried. Aye. Committee meetings are adjourned. Assuming the first and second is previously entered for MBBA and TSFC, all in favor of adjourning, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion is carried. The meetings are adjourned. Our next board meetings for MBBA and TSFC are scheduled for Thursday, April 13, 2017 at 8:30 a.m.
Okay. We're now going to move to the State Mortgage Agency action items. Item 13, a resolution approving 100% mortgage insurance on a $13,400,000 HFA permanent first mortgage loan for Moxie A. Rigby Apartments, Nassau County. This item was discussed and voted on earlier today's Mortgage Insurance Committee meeting and is now for vote by the State Mortgage Agency Board. There'll be no discussion on this item unless the directors so request. Move on to the votes.
Now before the board for approval is a resolution of Sunny May approving mortgage insurance and a commitment for the provision thereof for Moxie Rigby Apartments in Nassau County. Assuming the first and second previously entered for Sunny May, all in favor, please signify by saying aye. The motion.
Aye.
The motion is
carried. It was time to vote.
And the resolution adopted. Sorry,
we
guys.
How many cups of coffee did you have today? Item 14, resolution approving 100% mortgage insurance on an $11,677,500 HFA permanent first mortgage loan for Savannah Hall Apartments, New York County. This item was discussed and voted on earlier today's Mortgage Insurance Committee meeting and is now for vote by the State Mortgage Agency Board. There'll be no discussion on this item unless the directors so request. Let's move on to the votes.
I just want to note that on this item, Marge is
abstaining.
So now before the board for approval is a resolution of Sunny May approving mortgage insurance and a commitment for the provision thereof for Savannah Hall Apartments, New York County. Assuming the first and second is previously entered for Sunny May, noting Marge's abstention. All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion is carried. The resolution adopted.
Item 15, a resolution approving 100% mortgage insurance on a $9,880,000 HFA permanent first mortgage loan for Kingsbridge Heights Apartments, Bronx County. This item was discussed and voted on earlier today's Mortgage Insurance Committee meeting. Is now for vote by the State Mortgage Agency Board. There'll be no discussion on this item unless the directors so request. Alex?
Now before the board for approval is a resolution of Sunny May approving mortgage insurance and a commitment for the provision thereof for Kingsbridge Heights Apartments in Bronx County. Assuming the first and second is previously entered for Sunny May, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
The motion is carried and the resolution adopted.
Item 16, adoption of resolution authorizing the issuance of bonds, presentation of the ALCO report. I note that the director's folders contain revised materials on this item, which increased the bonding authorization by $32 million from what it is in the board books. And I think I am going to abstain on this note.
The city main board knows that different from what we see on the mortgage insurance fund, where we're approving a project-by-project resolution, the Sunny May single-family lending program runs on a constant basis, and we're always reserving loans and purchasing loans and need the ability to be nimble and get in the market when we have sufficient loan production to enter the market and to pick our spots depending on market conditions. So as is our norm, we come to the board once a year for broad authorization to continue the Sunny May lending program. Here we're asking for an amount not to exceed, I'm going to try to do the $32 million in my head, so that gets us to about $150 million. I mean, sorry, $1.05 billion of issuance during the year. That gives us the ability to do a couple of things, take advantage of possible refunding opportunities should the market rates allow for that, and also to be able to continue to fund our production. What we're asking for assumes production roughly of about $400 million. The authority gives us the ability to issue floating rate, fixed rate, economic refunding, replacement refunding, tax exempt, and taxable bonds.
And it's $1,049,390,000 as adjusted.
Are there any questions?
No.
And the ALCO report was attached.
And the ALCO report.
Okay. Now before the committee and board is a resolution adopting series resolutions and authorizing the issuance of bonds, assuming the first and second previously entered for the Sunny May Finance Committee. All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
The motion is carried. The resolution adopted. Assuming the first and second previously entered for the Sunny May Board, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
The motion is carried. The resolution adopted.
With my abstention.
The chairman.
Abstention.
Yes, the chairman has abstained on both.
Okay, we're going to move on to one second. There being no further items for the State Mortgage Agency Board and the State Mortgage Agency Finance and Program Committee. Alice will ask for a motion and a second to adjourn the meetings.
Assuming the first and second previously entered for the Sunny May Finance Committee, all in favor of adjourning, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
The motion is carried and the meeting is adjourned. Assuming the first and second previously entered for the Sunny May Board, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion is carried, the meeting adjourned. Our next Sunny May Board meeting is scheduled for Thursday, March 9, 2017 at 8:30 a.m. This is Mark Rogas' last meeting.
Thanks.
So we're going to ask for... Marge has been a great member of the Sunny May Board and the MIC in particular.
Marge, how many years? How long have you been on the board?
9 years.
9 years.
It's 9 years. And
Mike Friedman will miss your phone calls.
So will you.
Yes, no.
So will Wanda. So will Lorraine. Marion. I mean, you know, I've been really, when I think back, Priscilla, Deb, I've gone through a list of marvelous people. And you
warn
have
them all out.
New wonderful people. And it's been a pleasure. And I wish you all great, not just luck. Do what you have to do.
It's been a pleasure serving you.
Thank you. Yes. Thank you.
I guess moving on to the HFA items. Item 17, resolution authorizing financing approval in an amount not to exceed $104 million for 80 DeKalb Avenue.
I'd like to ask the board's indulgence. We went through the production of HFA earlier this morning, but I see behind me all of the people that made that possible. And I'm going to ask both legal and program folks to stand up and take a bow, and the bond group, because this is the team. Come on, everybody.
All of you.
Barbara, you too. I see
Roger,
people.
Mark.
I want everybody. These are the people that make this happen. They work tirelessly. to get all...
They were tired, actually.
Yeah, to get all those deals done. So starting with ADECAB is an existing project, which we originally financed in 2008. There's $104 million of bonds outstanding, and like many of this vintage project, they didn't have the capacity to do private placements in the plumbing of the resolution. So we're before the board to be able to refund the bonds and amend the resolution to allow them to change their credit enhancement facility. This is, still have a year to go on their original 10-year facility, but it does expire in 2018. And what they're doing is putting in place a much longer term execution. They have the ability to take advantage of relatively low interest rates, lock in 26-year fixed rate financing, and in the first 7 years, they have a fixed to floating swap. So they have an effective floating rate for the first 7 years, but this gives them the ability to lock in that rate right now.
Quick question. Is there a swap associated with this?
Yes, there is a swap. So they're locking in a fixed rate for 26 years. And for the first 7 years, they're doing a fixed to floating swap. So their effective borrowing cost is floating for that first 7 years.
Other questions?
Okay, now before the committee and board of resolutions that were transmitted in connection with the item, assuming the first and second previously entered for the committee. All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
The motion is carried and the resolution adopted. Assuming the first and second previously entered for the board, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
The motion is carried. Resolution adopted.
Item 18, resolutions authorizing financing approval in an amount not to exceed $14,700,000 for Savannah Hall Apartments.
Hi. So you'll see the next few items really continuing our momentum to not only to produce a lot more affordable housing, but a particular emphasis on supportive housing. And this is the first example of a few here. So this is financing for Savannah Hall Apartments, which is in the Bronx. It'll be new construction of 73 units, 50 of which will be set aside for low-income single and young adults suffering from mental illnesses. We are asking for an allocation of $14.7 million of bonds and $953,000 of 4% tax credits. You can see we're continuing our new approach to financing new construction, our green standards, and participate in that CPI initiative that was launched last year. This project leverages substantially. Our state partner HHAP is providing $3.5 million, and OMH is providing debt service of $10 million. This is one of the final ones we'll see that source. You'll see the next project, how we approach projects without that source. This is a New York 3 project, and the partners include Richmond providing the Litex construction letter of credit by Bank of America, permanent Sunny Mae mortgage that you just heard about. And the project is being developed by Lantern, who will also be doing the services for the residents. Any questions?
That's great. So this is new construction.
This is new construction.
The design seems like it's old construction. I mean, it's hard to tell, but it's new to most.
There was some fun debate about this design versus the next design, which are very different.
Okay.
We have different architectural styles and different opinions on them.
Seems much more contextual.
Yeah, right. Given the neighborhood context, right?
Okay.
That's fine.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Any other questions?
Okay, now before the committee and the board of resolutions that were transmitted that were in connection with this item, I note that chairman is recusing himself from this vote.
As a matter of fact, I'm going to be recusing myself on voting on items 18, 19, 21, and 22. So let's get that on the record now.
Noted.
Thank you, guys.
Noted.
Okay.
Assuming the first and second is previously entered for the committee and noting the recusal, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Assuming the first and second is previously entered for the board, all in favor signify by saying aye.
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 Motion is carried, resolution adopted.
With my recusal.
With your recusal, yes.
Still.
Yeah, yeah.
Item 19, resolutions authorizing financing approval in an amount not to exceed $36,850,000 for Kingsbridge Heights Apartments.
A second project in the Bronx, and as I mentioned, demonstrating the newer manner of financing projects. This is a project that also provides some more community development context as it's mixed income project, as well as provides a wider range of unit sizes, which is something we've talked about. This will be 136 units in the Bronx. 40 of these units will be supportive housing units. 27 will be units available to people earning up to 90% of area median income. We're asking for $36.85 million of bonds and $1.8 million of allocation of tax credits. Again, this will be participating in our new green features. We're seeking $15 million of supportive housing opportunity funds through the HTFC board later today. And again, that's the supplanting of what used to be OMH debt services, demonstrates the new manner of financing, as well as an allocation of state low-income housing tax credits. HPD is participating considerably in this project, which is quite common for projects of this nature, providing $10.2 million to the project. And the services are actually also being financed by New York City through DOHMH. Raymond James is the tax credit investor, and Citibank is providing the letter of credit, Sunny May providing the mortgage insurance. Project being developed in a partnership through B&B Supportive and L&M, who we've done substantial work with. And they will be partnering through with CUCS to provide the services, who also have a majority ownership in the managing member once the project is complete. Any questions?
Now, before the committee and the board, of resolutions that were transmitted in connection with the item, assuming the first and second is previously entered for the committee, noting the chairman's recusal, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
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 Gotcha. The motion to carry resolution adopted, assuming the first and second is previously entered for the HFA board, noting the chairman's recusal, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
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 Motion is carried, resolution adopted.
19.
That was 19.
Item 20, resolutions authorizing financing approval in amount not to exceed $36,850,000 for Moxie A. Rigby Apartments.
Hi. Sorry, Marion and I are laughing because
inside
I'm doing
joke.
A long, it's an inside joke. It's a Long Island project, and she's our Long Island person. So this is me stretching my veins here, doing Long Island.
Yeah, we're all a little delirious, aren't we?
Okay. Yeah, exactly. So that's what goes for funny in our office. Anyway.
I'm so worried about you guys.
Good, that's on the record. Okay. So this project is really fulfilling our desire to do PHA restructuring, but it's also a very important partnership with dealing with the impact of these storms that really had a substantial impact on Long Island with our partners of GOSER. This will be a $65 million investment to replace 101 units of public housing that were really damaged by Superstorm Hurricane Sandy. 100% of the units will be available to 60% of area median income households in Nassau, Suffolk. There's a wide range of bedroom sizes, which really matches the existing units that are being replaced. We are seeking $36.85 million of bonds.
Which fulfills your desire to have two projects
with the exact same bond amount, which we worked on that very hard. And
so that's what you spend your time doing.
That's extra time. That's what we do on the weekends. $2.4 million of low-income housing tax credits. We also be seeking $500,000 of Homes for Working Families subsidy. The project leverages a substantial amount of money related to the restructuring of the public housing and the impact of the storm, including CDBG National Disaster Recovery Funds of $5.5 million, GOSER funds of $9 million, and FEMA funds of $5.1 million. Boston Financial is providing the low-income housing credits. Capital One is the letter of credit, and Sunny May providing the permanent mortgage. insurance. Georgica Green is the partner that was selected through an RFP by the Freeport Housing Authority and identified this site. One of the things I want to mention is the project does have a very high cost, higher than we would normally see, and I wanted to make sure we gave some explanation about the reasons for that. First, it's a Davis-Bacon job because of the prevailing wages required by the project-based vouchers. There's demolition costs associated with the site, and the soil conditions are such that there are substantial costs. It's very important to note that the very high priority and importance of replacing this housing and the limited number of sites that could be chosen to replace it make it so that some financial decisions had to be made to make a site like this work. The unit sizes are also larger than one would see because of the replacement nature of the project needing to match the original project. And there are substantial resiliency measures being undertaken to protect the project should there be another storm. I think the most important point, though, is that in terms of using our housing resources, it's very normal. There's nothing out of the ordinary in terms of our subsidy provided to the project. And other resources that are really aimed at dealing with the impact of the storm and helping housing authorities that were impacted with the storm are really what's helping deal with the costs that couldn't be avoided due to the circumstances. Any questions?
Okay, so now before the committee and board, resolutions to be adopted, transmitted in connection with the item. Assuming the first and second is previously entered for the committee, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion is carried, resolution adopted. Assuming the first and second is previously entered for the board, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion carried, resolution adopted.
Item 21, resolutions authorizing financing approval in an amount not to exceed $8 million for Cornerstone Point Apartments.
This project is in Monroe County. Cornerstone Point will develop 66 units of senior housing, half of which will be supportive housing that are MRT eligible frail seniors. This is the second phase of a project that HCR was involved in the first phase with 9% credits, and this will be a $14.4 million investment in that community. The second phase is right on the same site. It was rezoned a few years ago, and it's been an important partnership with the local town there. We are asking for $8 million of tax-exempt bonds and $421,000 of low-income housing tax credit allocation. We will also be asking HTFC to provide $6.5 million of supportive housing opportunity program funds later today. City of Rochester's Housing Authority is providing the project-based vouchers, which are really what's driving the ability to develop this project. That was an important partnership, and the town of Greece is providing a pilot. This will be participating in our new green standards. Raymond James is providing the low-income housing tax credits, and Citibank is the letter of credit provider, with Sunny Mae doing the permanent mortgage insurance. This project is being developed by Rochester's Cornerstone Group, who obviously did the first phase, and they've done a lot of work with the agency. I think most recently they did the spa apartments. That was a Michelama preservation project we did a year ago or so. As I mentioned, these are MRT eligible populations, so it's really advancing one of our important goals. Any questions?
Questions? All right, now before the committee and board, are resolutions to be adopted, transmitted in connection with this item. Assuming the first and second previously entered for the committee with the chairman's recusal, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion carried, resolution adopted. Assuming the first and second previously entered for the HFA board with the chairman's recusal, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion carried, resolution adopted.
Item 22, resolutions authorizing financing approval in an amount not to exceed $89,885,000. Michelangelo Apartments. How do you choose to pronounce it?
You saved me there. Michelangelo is a 494-unit Michelama project located in the Melrose section of the Bronx. It is one of the 35 mortgages that we intended to refinance as part of the UDC acquisition, which we started in 2013. We have 5-year time period to get all of those done. We have 26 completed. We have another two that we expect to close, including this one, next few months, leaving seven on the hot list. And we're working away on those, and I think we have plenty of runway to get those all done. This project, like many of the other projects in the portfolio, was built in the mid-70s at a point where ugly seemed to be the overriding design theme in development. This is four interconnected buildings. The financing that we're asking for, which is up to $89.335 million in bonds and an allocation of $3.7 million of tax credits, will allow for the acquisition, including the repayment of the agency's first mortgage full, and $104,000 a unit in hard costs, which will include new kitchens, new baths, other interior improvements, particularly in the common areas, and most notably, replacement of the electrical heat system with a new hydronic system. This is something that we've seen in other projects of this vintage, and I'm doing this from memory, but I want to say that the savings that people have experienced from the new system exceed 50%. It's pretty significant. In addition to that, they're going to do a number of site work improvements and improvements to the roof. The project is approved for participation in the RAD 2 program. RAD 2 has been our big friend in making our way through the UDC portfolio, and 406 of the units in the project will be covered by a project-based rental assistance contract. The project contains a range of bedroom sizes, studios all the way up to four bedrooms. The developer for this project is an entity controlled by Metropolitan Development and Melrose Management. Metropolitan Development is an affiliate of MDG. We just closed on a loan with MDG. They were the lead part of the team redeveloping the NYCHA site out in Far Rockaway. We also did another Mitchell-Lama project, preservation project with them in Brooklyn, Marion Hine, which we financed here at HFA. Metropolitan Development, the other partner, Melrose Management. There's too many M's in this partnership. Melrose Management, the principal of that organization is Carrie Fields. Mr. Fields has been a partner in the development of over 10,000 units of affordable housing over the last 40 years. And for this project, BSR Management will serve as the property manager, and they oversee the day-to-day operations of over 1,000 units of affordable housing. The project will be financed through the agency's open resolution, and I hope we've clarified the language in the resolution so that it allows for a little more flexibility on the structure of how the mortgage will be secured. I think what's in the resolution anticipates a Fannie Mae-backed MBS. It may be, as we work through the details of that structure, that it's not a perfect fit for the open reso, and we may resort back to a Fannie Mae credit enhancement facility. So I ask for your approval with the resolution as amended to accommodate that.
Okay, so it'll be either that or Fannie Mae for credit enhancement.
Right, and if the board wouldn't mind, I would say, or any other credit facility that meets the agency standard for participation in the open resolution.
Okay.
The other thing I would say about this project and a number of the other ones that were before the board this morning is that we're trying to move them quickly. They all have commitments on tax credit pricing, this one at $1.16. I'm not saying that's the last time we'll see $1.16, but remember the projects before the board today have deadlines and must close by March or they're gonna lose their pricing. So we're really trying to get things done as quickly as we can.
As opposed to usual when we try to move.
Yeah, really
sitting around.
Filing our nails and getting our hair done.
now before the Committee and Board of Resolutions to be revised as set forth in Marion's presentation. Assuming the first and second previously entered for the committee with the chairman's recusal, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion is carried, resolution adopted. Assuming the first and second previously entered for the HFA Board with the chairman's recusal, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion is carried, resolution adopted.
Item 23 has been removed from the agenda. We're going to move to the AHC consent items. Item 24, resolution authorizing award of grant funds to certain projects located inside and outside of the city of New York. This is a consent item. There'll be no discussion unless board members so request.
Now before the AHC Board is a resolution of AHC authorizing awards of grant funds for certain projects located inside and outside of the city of New York. Assuming the first and second previously entered for AHC, all in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion is carried and the resolution adopted.
There being no further items for HFA Finance and Program Committee and the HFA and AHC Boards, Alex will ask for motions and seconds to adjourn the meetings.
Assuming the first and second previously entered for the HFA Finance and Program Committee, all in favor of adjourning, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion is carried, resolution adopted. Assuming the first and second previously entered for the HFA and AHC Board, all in favor of adjourning, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Motion is carried, the meetings are adjourned. Our next HFA meetings are scheduled for March 9th at 8:30 a.m. Thank you.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.